Gryphons, who are one place above them at 10th in the OUA standings. A reminder that coming up after this is the second game of a doubleheader between the men's teams of Guelph and Waterloo. Guelph in the white to your left, Waterloo in the black to your right. This is number 9, Taylor Crown, right side hitter, serving for the Gryphons. Waterloo goes to Spaulding, and Spaulding gets a fortunate bounce off the net. It's 1-0 Waterloo, she'll go back to serve. Scrambles to get it over, and it's blocked by the combination of Ng and Danielle Camps. Setter Kayla Ng and middle hitter Danielle Camps teaming up on the block there for Waterloo. It's 2-0 for the Warriors. Spaulding serves again, and Guelph watches it go deep. 2-1 for the Warriors. This is number 13, Devin Jones. The left side hitter serving now for the Gryphons. And that's Laura Klein, who can't find the Guelph court. Klein receives. In goes for the dump. Guelph recovers. Up by Kozak. Out to Klein. Klein with a tip. And it's another block by Ng and Camps. 3-2 for the Warriors. Kill Ng now will go back to serve. A bad pass. It's another Warriors point. 4-2 for the home team. And that's number 14, Aaron Bickle. The middle finding line there. 4-3 for the Warriors. This is number 10, Caitlin Krizmanich, serving for the Gryphons. Received by Klein, Ng. And that's number 13, Kristen Sheffield, who tools it off the block. Guelph just a little late getting that block up on the net. Waterloo able to capitalize. Laura Klein with the serve. Brooke Lloyd goes up and hit, but again, another block by Waterloo. Waterloo dominating here on the net early. 6-3. Klein with a serve. And that's number 14, Erin Bickle again. Showing her height and jumping ability as she comes through the middle and finds the court. It's 6-4 for the Warriors. Bickle serving now for the Gryphons. In goes to Oksana Kozak. And she hits it high and out. Kozak, Katie Spack, and Laura Klein now receiving for the Warriors. Bickle serves again. Off the net, Klein, Ng. And there it is, number 15, Danielle Camps. Finds the side of the block and gets the point. She'll serve now for the Warriors. It's 7-5 here. Klein keeps it in. It's Ng, Kozak, a hard-hitting Kozak finds a Gryphons player, but the Gryphons find the court on the return. Natasha Spalling back in the game now for the Warriors. Ng. Kozak. And Kozak hits it on the wrong side of the tape. Too low for the net. Tied up at 7 here. Early in the first set between Guelph and Waterloo. It's number 11, Caitlin Larson, serving for the Gryphons. Spack comes up for it. Ng. Spalling. Ng again. Spack will take it. She goes to Kozak. Guelph deals with it. And it's a Warriors point. Double hit by the Gryphons. Kristen Sheffield will go back to serve for Waterloo. 8-7 for the Warriors. And that's number 9, Taylor Crown, who wins the serve back for Guelph. Guelph having a lot of success here early with their middles. Brooke Lloyd serving now for the Gryphons. Kozak, Ng, back to Kozak. She keeps it up. Spalling wins the joust at the net. Guelph will get another go at it. It's a touch. Klein, Kozak. And that's number 13, Devin Jones again with the hit. It's touched by Waterloo, and Laura Klein unable to salvage that point. Kozak out of the game now, and number 6, Jillian Henderson in for the Warriors. Lloyd serves for the Gryphons. Klein, Ng, Spalling. And that's Devin Jones again with some success for the Gryphons. As Kristen Sheffield unable to get to the ball early enough to get a good pass. Lloyd serves. And it's 10-8 for the visiting Gryphons. Henderson. Klein gets it up. Warriors a little flustered now. Don't want to let the set get away from them. They're down by 3. And there it is. There's a timeout by the Warriors. ...11-8 for the Gryphons early. Warriors have done very well here at home this season, but have not fared the same way on the road. Earlier in January, they had 2 straight wins here against Windsor and Western, 3-0 and 3-1 respectively. But then they went on the road to Hamilton and Toronto, where they lost in three straight sets to McMaster, and then a close, hard-fought game against the Ryerson Rams, where they lost in 5 sets. They'll be looking for some more home success here tonight and next Friday when they take on York. Lloyd serves again. It's a bad pass by Henderson. Guelph capitalizes. It's 12-8 now for the visiting Gryphons. Klein, Ng, Spalling. Spalling will take it again. Kept up by Klein, Spack. Ng has to knock it over. Larson. And That's a hit by number 9, Taylor Crown. Again, having a lot of success here early tonight. It's been Crown and Jones that are seeming to cause the difference in the score here between the Warriors and the Gryphons. Henderson, unable to get it on the right side of the antenna. Lloyd serving for the Gryphons. Ng. Kozak. That's Jones. Spalling. Good heads-up play at the net. Klein gets it up. Kozak knocks it over. And that one's deep by number 9, Taylor Crown. The Warriors finally able to get the serve back. It's 14-9 for the visiting Gryphons. This is outside hitter Oksana Kozak serving for the Warriors. Klein, Ng, back to Klein. Hard swing by Klein. Ng has been great on the net early. She'll take that one herself. Guelph goes again to Krizmanich. Ng, Spalling. Crown, Ng, Klein. That's too deep by Klein. Waterloo having a tough time capitalizing here early. As Guelph is coming up with most of the points off the rallies. 15-9. For the Gryphons. Spack, Ng, Spalling. Spack, Ng, Spalling on the right side. Guelph deals with it again. That's Jones. Kozak, Ng, Camps. Sorry, Sheffield. She'll take it again. It's Ng. Now Klein with the tip. Neither team able to put it away. Not really a convincing point there by Guelph, but Waterloo with some poor communication, and we're at the 16-point timeout. 16-9 now for the visiting Guelph Gryphons. Waterloo having trouble early passing. Staying in some rallies, but not good enough passing to win the point. Gabrielle Jobst having some very intense words now with her team. They don't want to lose this first set here at home. Guelph and Waterloo met earlier this season at a tournament in Ottawa back in September, where Waterloo came out on top in a 5-sets win. This is the first time both teams have met in the new year. Number 9, Taylor Crown, the right side hitter, will serve for the Gryphons. It's 16-9 for the visitors. And out of the timeout, Crown misses a serve wide. Natasha Spalling now will try to regain momentum for the Warriors. That's not the way to do it. Into the net. It's 17-10 now. For the Gryphons. Number 13, Devin Jones, back to serve. It's received by Klein. Ng. kept up by Guelph. And Caitlin Krizmanich puts it in between the block. Waterloo has experienced a lot of success here in the first set. Perhaps their only real success on the net in terms of their blocking, but I let them down there. Ping. Guelph gets caught up on each other. It's an ugly point, but a point that Waterloo will take. Setter Kayla Ng with the serve. Guelph goes to Krizmanich. And there it is. There's the block again. And it's Kristen Sheffield and Danielle Camps teaming up on the net to keep the serve for Waterloo. Ng with the serve. Kanda, great hustle, keeps it in. There's Ng, Klein. Krizmanich, Ng, Spack. Kozak. Camps has to reach for it. But it pays off for Waterloo. 13-18. Good perseverance here by the Warriors to stay in this set. Ng will serve. Ng. And Sheffield. Waterloo back within four now in the first set. It's 14-18. And a timeout taken by the Gryphons. Both teams with 5 wins in the OUA regular season. The only difference, Waterloo with 9 losses, is they have played one more game than Guelph. Team 18 for the Warriors. Ng serves it. And the sprawling Sabu, the libero for Guelph, can't come up with it. It's a great point out of the timeout for Waterloo. Ng still serving. Trying to close out this comeback. Bickle swings at it, but the ball goes straight into the antenna. And now it's Guelph that seems a little out of rhythm. Ng with the serve. Larson, they go to Bickle again. Up by Kozak, then Ng. Camps takes it in the middle. Waterloo with another chance. Ng. Laura Klein hits it into the block. A little confusion in the Guelph court as to who is going to get that pass off the deflection. Number 1, Alicia Combe-Dingwall. Now into the game for the Gryphons. Krizmanich. Ng. Sheffield. It's a lucky bounce off the net. Sabu can only knock it over. And it's 18 all here at the pack. Waterloo fights right back. Guelph substitutes number 13, Devin Jones, into the game to try and stop the bleeding. There's Ng. And Alicia Combe Dingwall, on her first hit attempt, goes for the tip. And she takes a point for the Gryphons. 19-18 for the visitors. Krizmanich serves. Kozak. Aaron pass. Klein keeps it in. Poor communication there by Waterloo, but they're able to get it over the net. Number four, Brooke Lloyd, capitalizes. Lloyd has been sharp here in this first set in terms of her serving and her hitting. 20-18 lead. Krizmanich with the serve again for the Gryphons, who are ahead by two. Camps and Danielle Camps having a good first set for the Warriors. Waterloo doing well at the net, but perhaps down by one because of their passing. Lloyd hits it into the net, and Klein will go back to serve. It's all tied up at 20. The atmosphere here at the pack beginning to improve as the crowd now back into it. Klein with the serve. Larson goes for the tip. Ng saw it coming. And there it is. It's a point from number 13, Kristen Sheffield, as Waterloo takes the lead. And it's a timeout from the Gryphons. 21-20 lead for the home team Warriors as they have fought back here in the opening set. This would be a great set win here for the Warriors if they could come back. Could have come back and now take this. We mentioned already that the Warriors have York next Friday, who are currently first place in the OUA. Tomorrow, Guelph will face the Brock Badgers at home. Brock fifth in the OUA. Two tough games for both these teams coming up next. Both will be looking for a win here. And Guelph gets a great roll off that block. But it's on the wrong side of the net for Waterloo. 21 all now. This is number 14, Aaron Bickle. Serving for the Gryphons. Klein will take it. Ng. Camps. Kept up by Ng. Spack will take it. Kozak, she's had a quiet first set. But there she is. Keep it alive. And Sheffield hits it long. 22-21 now for the Gryphons. Timeout to Waterloo. Key contributors here early for Guelph, Aaron Bickle and Caitlin Krizmanich, who are both averaging above 2 kills per game. Waterloo will want to keep them quiet as they try to get a crucial 4 points here to close out this set. However, they are down 1. It's 22-21 for the Gryphons. Ng, Kozak. Now it's Larson. Up by Ng. Spack. Larson. And there's a block at the net. Great keep up by Guelph. But it's too many hits. And it's 22 all now. Natasha Spalling back in the front row for the Warriors. And number three, Alice Lee, in to serve for the Warriors. Up by Ng. Klein and Lee hustle to it. But they're unable to come up with it. Larson will go back to serve. It's 23-22. A close first set here at the pack. Guelph with the serve. Up by Kozak. It's a long pass. Sheffield able to recover. Backcourt hit by Klein. And that's Jones. And Devin Jones with a hard hit. And this is now set point. It's 24-22 for Guelph as they serve. Spalling out of the game. Number 16, Jillian Battenberg in the game now for the Warriors. Larson with the serve. Kozak. Ng. Kristen Sheffield able to keep the set alive. And it's 23-24. Sheffield will go back to serve. Big point for the Warriors. Jones, and Jones serves in the net. It's 24-24 going right down to the wire here in this first set. Sheffield with the serve. And it's deep. A tough spot in the game to miss a serve. 25-24 for the Gryphons. Number four, Brooke Lloyd, will try to close it out for Guelph. It's received by Klein. Ng. Kozak. There's a touch. Larson. Krizmanich. Kozak. Ng goes to Battenberg in the middle. She keeps it up. Then kept it by Klein. Ng with the awareness to knock it over. And it finds the back of the court. Waterloo not able to get a block up. And it's a 26-24 first set win for the Guelph Gryphons. We'll be back in a few minutes. Welcome back to the pack here at the University of Waterloo for the second set between the Waterloo Warriors and the Guelph Gryphons women's volleyball teams. First set taken 26-24 by the visiting Gryphons. Both teams sticking to similar lineups here. And both teams probably hoping for a bit more rhythm in the second game. It's Oksana Kozak. She had a quiet first set. She starts out serving for the Warriors. The scramble by Guelph early. In goes to Spaulding. Spaulding has experienced a lot of success there when she rolls right side. But not working early for her here against the Gryphons. Number 9, Taylor Crown with the serve. It's received by Kozak. Spaulding looking for the line, but she can't find it. And it's a point for Guelph. Spaulding taken out of the game. And it's number 16, Jillian Battenberg. Another middle brought into the game. Kozak will take it. Ng with the dump. Got some good awareness by Crown. Krizmanich will take it. Guelph scrambles. And Jones has to bump it over. Jones will take it now. Kozak. Ng. Klein. And Klein puts it on a good spot there on the block as she's able to put it in between Guelph and the net. Battenberg back to serve. 2-1 for the Gryphons. Larson. Jones. And Oksana Kozak having a tough game so far. She is usually a very, very strong point for the Waterloo attack. Klein. Kozak wants it. She gives it back to Klein. Waterloo keeps it up. And Sheffield takes it and knocks it over. Larson keeps it in. Puts it in a good spot for Lloyd. Ng takes it. Klein. Klein, Ng, camps. Larson knocks it over. Ng. Larson. It's the tip. Ng will go out to Klein, but it's kept in by Serbu. Kept up by Kozak. Spack will take it. She goes to Sheffield. Larson. And the tall middle, number 14, Aaron Bickle. Very tall figure out there on the court. Takes it and capitalizes. Kozak, Ng. Ng dumps it again. And there's no touch off the Bickle hit. And it's a point for the Warriors. They're down 2-4 here in the second set. Larson. She goes to Bickle. And Aaron Bickle. Very successful here for the Warriors. Or for Guelph, sorry. As they start up the second set with a 5-2 lead. Krizmanich will serve. Kozak. And it's set to the referee. And he won't help Waterloo with it. So Chris Minich will take it back to serve again. 6-2 for the Gryphons. It's back. Camps. Back takes it. Ing. Sheffield. Larson. Good pass by Kozak. Kozak out to Klein. It's close to the net. And too close to the net. 7-2. Another tough start here for the Warriors. Gabrielle Jobs recognizes that, and she takes a timeout. It's 7-2 here, early in the second set. Only three games left in the OUA regular season for Waterloo, all of which are home games. On February 4th, they host last place Lakehead at the PAC. And on Friday the 10th of February, they have the Brock Badgers. Number 10, Caitlin Krizmanich, the left side hitter, will serve for Guelph. It's taken by Klein. Ing. Camps. Sheffield. Klein knocks it over. Up by Brown. Larson. And it's number 4, Brooke Lloyd, who knocks it into a great Waterloo block. Waterloo starting to block well again now. Perhaps a way for them to get back into this second set. Klein with the serve. Jones. And that is a hard hit by number 4, Brooke Lloyd. Middle, Aaron Bickle with the serve now for Guelph. Klein. Ing. Camps gets up and hits it. But Guelph able to recover. Great hit by Camps. Larson wanted it. Ing goes to Sheffield. And it's two big hits from the Waterloo middles. And it pays off with a point. 4-8 for the home team. Camps will serve. Up by Serbu. Sheffield. And Sheffield places it in between the block. Another point for the Warriors. 5-8 for the home team. Waterloo on the left in the black. Guelph to the right in the white. No intention of making that rhyme. Ing keeps it up. The middle, Battenberg will take it. She goes to Sheffield. And it's Larson. Lloyd with the hit. And she tools it off the block. Brooke Lloyd having a successful set here for Guelph. And Larson will serve for the Gryphons with their 9-5 lead. Number 13, Kristen Sheffield, takes back the serve for the Warriors, and she'll go back to serve. Klein, Battenberg, Lloyd with this hit, Kozak. Kozak gets a point. Still not a good hit by her standards, but she'll take the point. It's 7-9 now. Waterloo within two. Can they get Oksana Kozak going here in the second set? Kristen Sheffield can't do anything with a pass. So Brooke Lloyd will now go back to serve for the Gryphons, who are up 10-7 here on the road. Klein, Ng. And that's Jillian Battenberg with the hit in the middle. Kozak still struggling as she serves it into the net. Number 9, Taylor Crown, serving for Guelph. Kozak, Ng, Battenberg. Number 14, Aaron Bickle, finds the linesman, but he's out of bounds. Point for the Warriors, 9-11 with the middle, Jillian Battenberg serving. She finds the net. Each time Waterloo takes a point back, they lose the serve again. Jones with the serve. Kozak, good pass to Ng. Miscommunication, but Waterloo still able to have the ball. Kozak, great spot to the back of the court. Kozak, Ng, and Klein with a rocket. Laura Klein. Very difficult to pass a Laura Klein hit, especially when it's that hard. Back, the libero will take it. She goes to Sheffield. Larson doing a lot of passing, probably more than Guelph would like. They want her to be setting. Krizmanich, Kozak, good rally going on here. Klein will take it. She goes line. Larson, Krizmanich again. And Krizmanich closes out the rally for Guelph as she tools it off the block. She will now go back to serve. The Gryphons ahead by 3, 13-10 in the second set. Klein will take it. Spack has to knock it over. Larson. Lloyd. Good block by Sheffield. And Aaron Bickle, unable to get over the ball. She knocks it long. Point to Waterloo. Laura Klein will serve. It's received by Jones. Lloyd's hit blocked. She'll take it again, though. Ng gets it up. It's a very good bounce from the net. Waterloo getting the home court advantage early from the net in these first two sets. Klein with a serve. Jones not prepared to reach for it, or unable to reach far enough for it. And now it's tied up at 13-all here. Laura Klein will try to take the lead back for Waterloo. Larson. And that's number 14, Aaron Bickle. When Guelph is able to get Bickle in the middle, they seem to be able to get the point. Harder for them to do that though now, as Bickle is serving. 14-13 for the Gryphons. Sheffield. It's Larson now. She goes to Lloyd. Guelph asking for a touch. And it's given by the linesman. 15-13. Bickle will serve again for the Gryphons. It's received by Spack. Ng, Sheffield, and Kristen Sheffield with another point for the Warriors. She's had a great first two sets here for Waterloo. Danielle Camps with the serve. Larson will take it. Great up by Ng. She'll take it off the Klein pass. That's Lloyd. Battenberg can't win the joust, but she keeps it in play. And there it is, Sheffield again. Picks out the back corner. And Guelph unable to pass it up. Camps with the serve. Up by Jones. It's Lloyd. Lloyd having a lot of success on the left side. And we're at the 16-point timeout. 16-15 lead for Guelph here in the second set. For those of you who have recently joined us, the first set was won 26-24 by the visiting Guelph Gryphons women's volleyball team. Coming after this, looking for an 8 o'clock start time, are the games between the men's volleyball teams of Guelph and Waterloo. Team 15 here at the pack for the second set between the Guelph Gryphons and the Waterloo Warriors women's volleyball teams. It's setter Larson who will serve. Kozak blocked by Guelph. Klein will take it from the back row. Great up by Krizmanich. Larson will take it. Spack. Ng. Jillian Battenberg. Larson, great pass in the middle to keep it up. Waterloo with another go. They go to Kozak. And now Guelph will go to Jones. Up by Ng. Klein. And Sheffield serves in the net. It's a tough point to lose for Waterloo, but they're still within two. Larson now with the serve for the Gryphons. Klein. And there it is. In the middle, Jillian Battenberg. She's had a good second set here for the Warriors. We're now down by one. Another person who has played well in the second set, Kristen Sheffield, will serve for the Warriors. Sabu, Larson, Jones. And Jones able to get the right angle on the block. She knocks it off the block and out of bounds. Brooke Lloyd now with the serve for the Gryphons, who are up by two, 18-16. It's received by Klein. Battenberg will take it in the middle, and she finds some space. Jillian Battenberg taking the serve back for the Warriors. miscommunication there by Waterloo. And Guelph takes it right back. Both teams exchanging serves and points quite regularly. But if it keeps going this way, Guelph is going to come away with another win this set. It's the hit by Klein. Krizmanich, Spak, Ng. They go to Klein again. She tips it. Waterloo getting the blocks up, just unable to direct them into the Guelph court. This is number 9, Taylor Crown, with the serve, 20-17 for the Gryphons. Spak, in goes to Battenberg. Guelph recovers. Spak, good up. Kozak wants it. She goes to Klein. Larson goes to Jones. And Jones, with a great court awareness, she finds some space right there in the middle. And there's a timeout by Waterloo, 21-17.
Timeout Waterloo with a ball game, 21-17.
Waterloo able to get some hits and some tips in. They're putting them in good spots. But Guelph's passing here, it's a reason for their lead. ...21-17 for Guelph. Number 9, Taylor Crown with the serve for the Gryphons. The pack starting to fill up here. Ng goes back court to Sheffield. Sheffield looking for the back corner, but she puts it too deep. A sub now is number 6. Rebecca Bro comes into the game to serve for number 9, Taylor Crown. Guelph looking for Bro to serve out this set. She puts it to Lee, who's in the game now for Waterloo. Bro knocks it over. Sheffield, in goes to Klein. Klein with a hard hit. When Klein seems to get behind the ball like that for Waterloo, it appears to be an instant point for the Warriors. Jillian Battenberg with the serve. Klein looking for the back of the court, but it's kept in by Lloyd, who's also played well here tonight. Danielle Camp swings at it. Larson. Jones. And a sprawling Alice Lee, unable to get to the ball. Spak keeps it up. Ng. Camps. Camps picks the line. Great eye by Danielle Camps at the net. Kayla Ng will serve now for the Warriors. Up by Lloyd. Larson. Krizmanich. Ng. Klein with another hard hit. Lloyd and Guelph recover. They go to Krizmanich again. And it is deep. 23-20. Waterloo hanging around. And Guelph brings in number 7, Stephanie Vickers, a left side hitter for Krizmanich. Kayla Ng, the setter, serves it long. It's 24-20, set point. And that's a tough point in the match to miss a serve. Krizminich will come right back into the game. It's a very quick sub for number 7, Stephanie Vickers. But Guelph wanting Krizminich in to serve out the set. 24-20. Up by SPAC. Ng has to go to it. Klein with a hard hit. And you could hear it. Number 4, Brooke Lloyd, just hit it wrong. Kozak back in the game for Lee. Waterloo will be looking for a bit more offense from Kozak. As they try to come back and take this set. It's 24-21 for Guelph. Sheffield and Klein with the awareness to watch it go out off the block. And that's a point for Waterloo. Guelph subs number 1, Alice Combe-Dingwall, into the game for Aaron Bickle. Klein. Larson. Great play at the net again by Camps. She wins the joust again, but Guelph able to keep it alive. And there it is. 22-24. The Waterloo men's team likes it. But the Guelph coaching staff does not. It's 24-23 for the Guelph Gryphons. Waterloo with 3 straight points to keep them in this set. Looked like it was going to be easy closeout for the Gryphons, but Waterloo showing some perseverance and hanging around. They want to be able to close out the comeback this time. Down by 1. Guelph took the first set in similar fashion. 26-24. Number 9, Laura Klein, serving for the Warriors. She'll want to make sure she wasn't iced out of that timeout. Important serve for Waterloo. She goes deep with it. Larson, Lloyd, and it's a block at the net by the combination of Sheffield and Camps. 24 all here at the pack. And number 14, Aaron Bickle, back into the game. You don't want to jinx it, but this would be a great comeback for Waterloo here if they were able to come back and win this. Pivotal set for the Warriors. Good serving again by Klein. And it's 25-24. Bickle, instant success when she comes back into the game. Just some miscommunication there. Waterloo unable to capitalize off the tip. And Bickle will go back to serve. Possible set point. SPAC. Ng. Sheffield, Larson gets it up. Jones will serve, will hit from the back row. And there it is. 25-25, Waterloo hanging around. Camps with the serve. Kozak wins the joust. Ng goes to Sheffield. Sheffield finds the back of the court. And there's a block, but it's kept up by Guelph. Kozak, good pass. They go to Sheffield in the middle, and it's a huge point for Waterloo. 26-25, possible set point. Danielle Camps trying to serve out this set. A great comeback taking place here by Waterloo. Larson. Great up by Klein. Ng. Kozak can end it here. It's a big hit. Lloyd goes towards the bench, but she's unable to come up with it. And that is a great win for the Warriors. 27-25. First two sets nail biters here at the pack. First set taken 26-24 as the Warriors unable to close out their comeback. And Guelph takes that first set. But in the second set, Waterloo, similar comeback, although this time it results in a win, 27-25. We'll be back here in a few minutes with a third set from the pack. Welcome back to the pack here at the University of Waterloo for the third set between the Waterloo Warriors and Guelph Gryphons women's volleyball teams. First set taken 26-24 by the visiting Gryphons, who are tier left in the white. But the second set taken 27-25 by the Warriors, who are in the black on the right. Larson with the serve. Kozak. It's a tough way to start out the third set by Oksana Kozak. And the first point goes to Guelph. Larson. Spack, she's had a good game. Jillian Battenberg in the middle. Lloyd, good block by Battenberg. Jones, Ingle go for it. Now Kozak. Kozak still unable to get going. You wonder why. She normally is, besides Klein, the major offensive weapon for the Warriors. 2-0 for the Gryphons. Ing. They go to Kristen Sheffield. Larson. Lloyd. Kozak. Battenberg swings at it. And she'll take the serve back for the Warriors. The middle, Jillian Battenberg. Will now serve. Guelph on the net. or in this case under the net. So it will be a point for the Warriors and Julian Battenberg, who will now serve. Larson. The Guelph goes to number 9, Taylor Crown, in the middle. She looks for the line, but is wide by about a foot. 3-2 for the Warriors. And number 13, Devin Jones, finds the net. Both teams taking a little while to get started offensively. But it's working for the Warriors. Good serve by Battenberg. Lloyd will take it for the Gryphons. Passed up by Battenberg now. Ng. She goes to Sheffield, right side. Sheffield again. Sheffield with a deep hit. And the libero, Cerbu, unable to get for it, unable to get to it, and trying to make a good pass for Guelph. Battenberg will serve again for the Warriors, who are up 5-2. Goes into the net. Larson keeps it up. Puts it too deep for any Guelph player to salvage. She'll now come out of the game as number 18, Mackenzie Grant, another setter, gives her a rest. Grant puts it out to Jones, who gets over it. Waterloo with a 7-2 lead, which provokes a timeout by the Guelph Gryphons. A better start here by Waterloo. But they do know how easy it is to get back into a game. They want to keep this momentum going against the Guelph Gryphons. Jillian Battenberg with a good serving spell here for the Warriors, who are up 7-2. Lloyd will take it. And it's too far in front of the sprawling Kayla Ng to pass up. Lloyd will serve now. Pass up by Laura Klein, who goes, and in goes to Danielle Camps, and Guelph passes it into the onlooking crowd. Big point again by the Warriors. A lot of scrambling on the Guelph side. They're able to keep it up, but not able to get it over. Kristen Sheffield set another good start to this set. Now serving for the Warriors. And the passing just not good enough for Guelph here early. Devin Jones out of the game now, and number 7, Stephanie Vickers, in on the left side for Guelph. It's a big hit by Krizmanich, but Klein deals with it, and she'll take a back row hit. And she puts it short. Everything working out here now for the Warriors. Alicia Combe-Dingwall in the game for Taylor Crown. Guelph trying to change up the chemistry out there on the court. Krizmanich, and it's a good block by Camps. Klein will take it. In goes to Camps. She tips it. Waterloo very happy with the way things are going. But Guelph coach Paul Funk very, very disappointed in his team, as they are now down 12-3 here on the road in the third set. Waterloo with all the momentum here. They do have the crowd behind them. And for the first time out of these three sets, they are now in the driver's seat. Up 12-3. Kristen Sheffield with the serve for the Warriors, who are up by 9. She goes deep. Krizmanich has to bump it over. Camp swings at it. Good up by Ng. Camps will take it again off this back hit. And it's a wayward pass by Guelph. 13-3 now. Waterloo with what is probably the largest lead that either teams have had. And a great serve by Sheffield. 14-3 for Waterloo as they are cruising here. For Guelph, the 16-point timeout can't come soon enough. Although I'm sure they'd rather claw back, but they can't do it that way. Waterloo simply serving now and able to get points off the serves. Guelph able to take a point back there. Waterloo will want to make sure they don't give up momentum. 15-4. Klein passes up. Ng. She goes to Kozak. And Oksana Kozak is now rolling. 16-4 for the Warriors. By far the most dominant either team has looked here. Waterloo carrying that momentum from the last game, as they'll look to close out this set and hopefully the next one. For all the home fans here at the PAC. Strong point for Guelph early was their passing. But for what seemed like a 12-point spell in there, Guelph unable to pass the ball up. And Waterloo has capitalized. Can they close out the set here with Oksana Kozak serving? Kozak. It's kept up, but Sheffield can't get it over. That's number 14, Erin Bickle, with the point out of the timeout. She's very difficult for Waterloo to stop when she gets it in the middle. Stephanie Vickers with the serve. She serves it below the tape. Never a good thing to do in volleyball, especially when your team is trailing by a score of 16-5, which is now 17-5. Warrior lead. Danielle Camps with the serve. And it goes into the bench. Paul Funk unsure what's going on here with his Guelph Gryphons. Serbu with a good pass. But there's Kayla Ng and Julian Battenberg at the net. Waterloo getting a lot of points on the net off of blocks. Danielle Camps with the serve now. It's a block again by Battenberg and Klein. Kozak, Ng, Battenberg in the middle, and she's unable to get over top of it. 19-6 for the Warriors. Griffin star Caitlin Krizmanich now with the serve. Klein with a rocket of a hit. It's a double hit by Guelph. Point to the Warriors. Number one, Michaela Klee in the game for Waterloo to try and serve out this set. Larson back in the game as the setter for Guelph. Klee with the serve. It's 20-6 for Waterloo. Great pass up by Kozak. Klee. And Klein gets blocked at the net by the Gryphons. Gryphons giving up a lot of lineup with height they have out there now. Although Combe Dingwall now in the front court. But Bickle in the back court. Which is good news for Waterloo. Larson, Lloyd. Lloyd keeps it up. Larson will go back to her. And Laura Klein, unable to get her hands up. It's 20-8. Waterloo just needs 5 points to close out this set. And there's a block by Brooke Lloyd, for the Gryphons, who are now only down by 11. Though it seems a big deficit, we have seen Waterloo come back twice here. Can Guelph do the same? Klein, another block by the Gryphons. Larson, Spack comes up for it. She's played well today. And there it is, Jill Battenberg. Had a great set here for the Warriors. Klein comes out of the game. And her sub is Alice Lee. Typically libero. She is in to serve out this set. And she only needs 4 points, 21-9 for the Warriors. Great serve. Lloyd recovers. Lee will take it. Kozak with the hit. Lloyd. And Lloyd trying to keep the Gryphons in it. They're down 21-10 against the Warriors. And Larson, the setter, now serving. And she will be in the backcourt for the Gryphons. And there it is, Kristen Sheffield wins the serve back for the Warriors, who are now up 22-10. One would assume, based on the way the Warriors have played here, that they should be able to close out this set. Jillian Battenberg serving and trying to do that. Lee goes for it. That's a point to the Gryphons. Lloyd will now go back to serve. 22-11. Lloyd and the Gryphons trying to erase the deficit. Kozak gets it up. Sheffield, it's a scramble. Lee forced to bump it over unconvincingly. Kozak keeps it alive. Krizmanich, Spak. Kozak, Lloyd. And there's a call. Guelph under the net. And Waterloo will take that point, 23-11. Taking Waterloo a little long to close out this set. And number 13, Devin Jones, back into the game for Guelph. Kristen Sheffield now serving for the Warriors. Lloyd sets it over. Camps with the tip. And Guelph unable to use that tip effectively. So they had a chance to pass it up. 24-11. Guelph's passing, letting them down here in this third set. Possible set point for Sheffield and the Warriors. Camps got up on the net to try and block it. Guelph gets a good bounce. Received by Kozak. She'll take it back. Big hit, but Sheffield now willing to go into the bleachers. And it's 13-24 for the serving Guelph Gryphons. Another chance at closing out the set for the Warriors. And Guelph serves into the net. 25-13 win here for the Warriors. 25-13. The first set taken 26-24 by Guelph. Second set 27-25 by the Warriors. And then in more convincing fashion, the third set taken 25-13 by the home team Waterloo Warriors. We'll have the fourth set and possibly a chance for Waterloo to close out this game. It's coming up in a few minutes. Welcome back to the pack here at the University of Waterloo. For the fourth set between the Guelph Gryphons and the Waterloo Warriors. Waterloo up 2-1. Trying to close out here at home where they have experienced more success than on the road. Laura Klein to the left, serving for the Warriors. Larson. Good up by Ng. Spack will take it. And Kristen Sheffield hits it long. Number 13, Devin Jones, now serving for the Gryphons. Battenberg reaches and gets a touch on it, able to get it over. Kozak, Ng, Sheffield, and Sheffield puts it in between the block. But for a small successful spell there in the last set, Guelph able to get their blocks up, but not really up at the net. Close enough to capitalize and get some points. Klein, Ng, Sheffield continues the momentum from the last set. 2-1 lead now for the Warriors. Two big points from Kristen Sheffield. The other middle, Jillian Battenberg with the serve for the Warriors. Kozak goes deep. Larson, Krizmanich, Klein. A tough pass there from Laura Klein, but a good hit by Krizmanich. And she will now go back to serve for the Gryphons. It's tied up at 2 here in the fourth set. Klein. Ng knocks it over. Lloyd. Good block again from Waterloo. Lloyd. And Lloyd, off a pretty scrambled play, able to find some space in the Waterloo court. Warriors would be disappointed they didn't do better with that. Krizmanich serving again for the Gryphons. And Klein not passing well here early. By Klein. She seemed unsure about whether she actually wanted to pass it or not, and realized it was headed in a little too late. Krizmanich. Waterloo barely gets it over, having trouble passing here early. Lloyd. Ng gets it up, and she'll take it now. Great hit by Kayla Ng. Lloyd. And Brooke Lloyd can really hit the volleyball. It's a 6-2 lead for Guelph. Warriors will want to make sure they don't let this one get away from them. And Kristen Sheffield. That's more like it from Waterloo. Warriors down by 3. Sheffield with the serve. And number 14, Erin Bickle. Head space in the middle. She's really able to get up, but unable to find the court. Sheffield serving for Waterloo. It's a bad pass by Jones. both teams going through spells of some bad passing. Sheffield, Larson, Lloyd. Klein swings at it, but she hits the tape. Pack filling up in anticipation of the men's game. We've got a great women's game going on right now. And there it is. 6-7 now for the Warriors. Danielle Camps. The middles Camps, Sheffield, and Battenberg having great games here for the Warriors tonight. And we're all tied up at 7. More miscommunication and bad passing by the Gryphons. As they give away their early lead. Kozak with the serve. It's back. Ng. And Klein. That was a perfectly hit ball. Finds the white line at the back of the court. That prompts a timeout from the Guelph Gryphons as Waterloo appears to have all the momentum. Up by 1-8-7 here early in the fourth set. Waterloo trying to close out the night. Between the men's teams of both Guelph and Waterloo coming up as soon as this game is done. We could still go to 5 sets and then the men will have to wait, although they are aiming for 8 o'clock start time. Oksana Kozak with the serve for the Warriors. Larson. And there's a block at the net. Danielle Camps. 9-7 lead for the Warriors. As they continue their great blocking on the net against Guelph. Kozak with the serve. Larson. Camps takes it in the middle. Larson. She goes out to Lloyd. Been very consistent tonight. Ng. Klein goes to the tip. Larson takes it. She goes to Lloyd. Ng to Sheffield. Lloyd. It's taken by Kozak. Ng. And Klein gets behind it. But a great pass by Krizmanich. Ng dumps it. And Waterloo gets the point. 10-7. Some great play by both teams. Guelph unable to keep up with the barrage of Waterloo attacks. And there's a tough pass off the serve. It's a crummy way to give up points by the Gryphons. We're now down by 4, 11-7 lead. Oksana Kozak serving for the Warriors. And she makes that lead a little bit smaller by knocking it out of bounds. 11-8 now for the Warriors. The setter Larson back to serve for Guelph. Up by Klein. Ng. Klein takes it. And Klein with a huge hit. They go to Camps. Klein will take it. Not sure what the call was there. But the point does go to the Warriors. We're now up by 4, 12-8. Danielle Camps with the serve. And she puts it wide. Waterloo wants to close out this set. They have to start capitalizing on their serves. Brooke Lloyd now serving for the Gryphons. She's been very consistent here tonight. Set a little bit too low for Jillian Battenberg. And Lloyd will serve again. Gryphons now down by two. 12-10. Klein. Ng. Goes back to Klein. Gets a big hit on it. And Guelph can't pass it up to the net and get it over. And it's a great serve by Ng as she goes cross court and goes right for the sideline. Kayla Ng with a serve. Larson will take it. Jones, she comes up swinging. And Guelph again, unable to pass off those hard Waterloo hits. The speed and power with which Waterloo is hitting the ball now. Very difficult for Guelph to handle. So Waterloo has now jumped out to a 5-point lead, 15-10. Jones pops it up. And Lloyd can't get it over. We're at 16 points. So it's a timeout. 16-10 lead for the Warriors. Take it. Larson. Jones with the tip. And there's no one there to come up with it. As Jones able to evade that block and take the serve back for the Gryphons. Waterloo up 16-11. Kozak receives. Larson. Krizmanich. Klein with another big hit. There's no touch there as Jillian Battenberg hits it into the net. Taylor Crown serving for Guelph. We're down by four here in the fourth set. Kozak, she'll take it back row and doesn't connect on it the way that she would have liked. Knocks it out. Thank you. gets a right side. And Jones finds the court. 16-14. Instead of rolling over this time, Guelph now sticking with the Warriors. Down by two. Dang. Battenberg. And Julian Battenberg takes the serve and the point for the Warriors. Captain Laura Klein now serving. Good awareness to find some open court there. Now 17-15 for the Warriors. Jones with the serve. Taken by Klein. Ng goes to Battenberg in the middle. Klein will take it. Ng goes out to Kozak. And Oksana Kozak now starting to exert her influence on the game. Danielle Camps back in into the front court for the Warriors, who are now up 18-15 in the fourth set. It's a deep serve by Jill Battenberg. Guelph scrambles and recovers. Ng, they go to Kozak again. Kozak starting to get into some rhythm. Lloyd, it takes a deflection. And too much a deflection off the block for Battenberg to get to it. Krizmanich now with the serve for the Gryphons. But she wastes it and knocks it into the net. There's a timeout by Guelph as they are down 19-16 to the Waterloo Warriors. Warriors up 2-1. Trying to get that all-important third set. And end the night for Guelph. After this game, we have the men's game between Waterloo and Guelph. This is Kristen Sheffield with the serve for the Warriors. Jones, Larson. Sheffield dives for it. But it's too far and the Gryphons will take the point. 19-17. Guelph hanging around. Ng goes to Kozak out on the left side. She hits it with some power. Sheffield takes it. Ng goes to Camps. Waterloo a little angry that that ball was hit at them after the whistle was blown. Everyone's settled now. There's a joust at the net. Danielle Camps. Great effort there, and it's 21-17. Taylor Crown out of the game for the Gryphons. Kozak with the serve, and she'll take that point. Oksana Kozak has not been dominant here tonight in the way that we would have expected. But now is a good time for her to get going as she tries to close out this set. It's 22-17 for the Warriors. Kozak passes up. Ng barely gets to it. She trips over Camps. It's a point for the Gryphons, still down by four. Kozak will come out for Alice Lee, who's in as a passer. Larson with the serve for the Gryphons. Ng. Camps, it's blocked. ...22-19 now. Laura Klein with the hit, and Guelph can't direct that block into the court. ...23-19 for the Warriors. Danielle Camps trying to serve out the set and the match. Lloyd gets to it. It's taken by Jones. Big hit. They go to Battenberg in the middle. Now Lloyd up by Sheffield. But it's a poor pass. 23-20. Guelph staying in the game. Kenbrook Lloyd. Keep Guelph in the match. It's a poor pass by Waterloo as they let Guelph hang around. And that prompts a timeout by Gabriel Jobst. 23-21 here for the Warriors. Unable to close out this set. Pack still lively. Filled with many local supporters, both from Guelph and Waterloo, and several area volleyball teams, notably the Mitchell Blue Devils. 23-21 here for Waterloo. Lloyd with the serve. Lee. Laura Klein. And it's a huge hit from Laura Klein. 24-21. Set and match point here. Kayla Ng. With a chance to end it. Larson. Waterloo with some great hustle to keep it alive. Larson. Jones. And that ends it. Waterloo wins 25-21. So after a close first set loss, 26-24, Waterloo comes back and wins the next sets 27-25, then 25-13, and finally 25-21 to end the evening on a high point. Coming up after this, we have the men's games between Guelph and Waterloo. We'll be back in a few minutes.